Hi guys, Paul here. Thanks for checking out the video. I really do appreciate it. Please remember to like and subscribe. Again, bear with me. I'm new to this, so I will be making more videos as we go. So the more subscribers and likes I get, the more motivated I'll be to do it. I'm kidding. I'm going to do it anyway. So today I'm going to show you how to change the motor on the HS340 mini drone. These little drones are so much fun to fly. I was just bummed when my B motor went out on it and I couldn't fly it anymore. I didn't think it was possible to get motors to replace it, but to my surprise, I searched it on Google and I found Amazon actually carries them. You get a two pack, an A and B motor, so an A arm and a B arm motor, and they are color coded with the wires, so you'll know where they go for the most part. They're about just under 12 bucks. I think it was like $11.90 or somewhere around there for a two pack. I will put the link in the description so you can click on it and go right to it and get yourself some motors if you need to, because it would be a shame to just toss this drone to the side. They are so much fun to fly, especially inside, like on a day like today where it's just storming out and rainy. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what the problem is I'm having, and it's my B-arm, front B-arm motor. And you can see there it wants to spin, but it won't. So it keeps stopping. And that's the one we're going to replace. So we're going to turn all this off, set this aside, turn him off. We're going to pull the battery out, and we'll put this over here for now. And then once we get it all apart and reassembled and the new motor in, we're going to put it up and fly it. And I'm going to show you how to do it with just a pair of scissors, a screwdriver, and some handy dandy electrical tape. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to take the blade off the motor or propeller off the motor that I'm wanting to replace. This way when I disassemble the whole thing, I know what motor it is without having to look or turn it all over and it falling apart or whatnot. So I believe there's 18 total screws to take this little guy apart. And I'm going to start with the four top screws first. And I believe that's all there is just four on the top. And here we go. These screws are really tiny. So one cool thing about the screwdriver that came with the drone, this is the one that came with this drone, is it is magnetic. So you can see the screws will just stick to it, and it really comes in handy when you're putting it back together, because these things are almost impossible, see, to hold on to. And with me, Mr. Shaky Hands, it makes it a great tool. So I'll set all those over there so we hopefully don't lose any of them. So right now I'm not going to talk anymore. I'm going to do these screws and we're going to really pick up the pace here. So get this last one out and show you. All right, let's pick up the pace. This is going to take forever. Snap it off, hold it upright, guys, and then just there you go. You can put the bottom body aside. Voila, there you have it. Now you can see the drone's upside down, so it is backwards from when it was upside right or right side up. I said that backwards. This is the motor we want to replace. And you can see here, I will take the motor out of the bag, maybe if I can open it. So these are the two motors you get, and you can see that the B arms are the red and kind of bluish color, and your A arms are the black and white color. So it doesn't matter which one goes where. So we need this one here. Make sure these are separated. And just be super careful. They're really, really thin wires. So the motor just pops out like so. There you go. And the wire just kind of comes like this. And that's all you have. So now the best thing to do is to snip the wire up closer to this motor that is no good. And you just take your scissors and voila, one bad motor there. And you have your two wires here. And again, I apologize for the shaky hands, but now we're going to strip the wires. So just take your scissors and slowly pull up on it, and you'll see right here it came off. So it did strip it, which is good. Hopefully we didn't kink the wire. I'm just going to put those together a little bit. Then you're just going to want to take the same thing with this one, and I don't know if it's going to be enough wire coming out of here to do the splicing, so I'm going to try to strip this one again, and there we go. I think we got it. We got another blue piece lying somewhere. Really hard to see this stuff. I even have glasses on, and it's hard to see it, but it's pretty simple. Just grip it there. There's the blue piece that came off, so it did strip. Just make sure you hold the lower part of this wire right here really secure, you guys, so you don't pull it off the motor or the drone. And then don't squeeze the scissors hard. Just want enough you can pull it up and strip this bad boy off just like that. There it is right there. Perfect. Okay, now I'm going to try to do it with the lengths the wires already are, and I'm hoping that's going to work, and we can just tuck it down in here with the screwdriver, and I'm going to try to tuck it down in and get rid of all the slack, and we're going to see if that works, because we don't have a whole lot of wire to play with. But I'm going to pop the motor in to the drone first, pop this into the arm, and I'm going to make sure the wires are kind of facing the back side there. So that's in there. So then we're going to take these here and we're going to try like hell to splice these top pieces together and hope they work. And we'll twist them on really good. That looks like they're connected. So what I'm going to do now, you guys, so this isn't pointy like this, is I'm going to bend this over like so. Just like that, and I'm going to tape it like that. So I already have some pieces pre-cut. Tape will not add any or a whole lot of extra weight to the drone. So you're all right there. You may have to trim it up a little bit better, but I think other than that, you'll be okay. So what I'm going to do after I get these together like so is I'm probably going to just tape the four wires here together as well, just to give it a little better. So there we go. I've got the wires together. They are separated inside here with the electrical tape. So now what I'm going to do now is attempt to push these wires down inside and see if this is going to work or if we're going to have to shorten it. So here we go. Let's see what we got here. And hope we don't pull these damn things apart. So, gotta get these down here. Like so. Not as easy as it looks. Alright, so push those down there. Push this into here, like so. Try to push these down inside the drone a little bit more, just so I have a little more room to play with here. Because I could probably bend this around here like this, as long as I don't go and block that screw hole. And attempt to push this into here like so. Come on. Do it just like that. And I think my wires are pretty cleared here. So now, if you have steadier hands than I do, please feel free to shorten these wires up. But I didn't want to shorten them too much because I was afraid that I wasn't going to have enough wire. So concerned about this one here on the end, but I think we're going to be all right. It doesn't look like I'm blocking any of the screw holes, so I'm going to attempt to snap the body back on here around. I don't see any wires sticking out, so I think we're pretty much good there. We're going to find out when we go to start this puppy up. Still not liking any of this looks over here. You know what? I probably use this blade and push it in there better. Oh, look at that. Oh, that blade came in handy right there, didn't it? So, I want to push this one down in here more. Now, let's see what happens. Oh, that's a pretty good fit right there. So, let's see. Let's just get this thing together so we don't lose it. See if it'll go together anyway. Oh, yeah, my screw is catching, so I'm close enough. All right, I think I got it right there. Not the greatest, but we may have done it here. So I'll put this one, oh. Watch when you put the one in by the motor here, because as you can see, the motor has a magnet. It's really strong, and it will pull this little screw out. So I'm not sure. How this is going to work. I'm going to attempt to jab it in there. Where did it go? Oh my goodness. Attempt number 453, and that didn't work either. So let me see if I can get this thing to go down in here with my finger first, because that's not going to work. There we go. Should have done that to begin with. Let's see, is this one open? Yep, I have a connection. It looks like it is putting it together pretty good here. Alright, so the real test is going to be if this thing actually flies and the motor's in there right. Alright, so everything's on. We're going to put all the screws back in. And we're going to see what we got here. Okay guys, it's time for the test. So we're going to pop the battery back in here, see if that fits in. Oh, it did. Alright, do we have power? We have power. Do we have synchronization? We do. Gyro calibration? We have gyro calibration. Here we go. Oh, look at that. Voila, we just replaced the motor HS3
for you guys. It wasn't pretty, but we did it. And that's how you do it with what you got. So we're good. I'm going to clean this up and I'm going to go put this bad boy up and see if I can fly him and see how it works. And I'll bring you with me so you guys can see if it made any difference in how this thing flies.
Okay, guys, here we go. Here's the test. I have the app open, so the Wi-Fi is still working. The camera still works. Now we're going to see if this bad boy still wants to fly. I'm going to start the motors. You can see right there, the engines are working. So here we go. I'm probably going to have to trim the hell out of it, but let's give it a shot. It's flying. It's actually flying. We did it. And the trim is not that bad. Oh, that's so awesome. I absolutely love this little drone. The fast spin works, so that's good. I'm going to get it over this coffee table, and then we're going to check out the 360-degree flip. And let's see.
Great hold. The altitude hold still working really good. Maybe a little bit of trim, but not much. All right, we're going to come over here and we'll do the flip. See if that works. We got blessed today and have a really nice day outside at the end of June in Texas. So we have the windows open, and I think there's a draft coming in that's making it move around that much. So let me see what I can like get them to turn out just a little bit better. Yeah, that's pretty good. He's going. Check it out, man. It is working. It wasn't a pretty repair, but it did the job. I have Peanut, as I call this drone, that's his nickname, Peanut, is working again. I'm so excited now. So let's do a flip and see if it works. I'm hoping it does, but here we go. Man, he's just drifting all over. I don't want to do it while he's drifting like that. Hold on, guys. Let me see what I can do here. All right, let's try that. Get him over here, and we're going to try to do the flip, so, all right, here we go. Ha, 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 we did it. I want to do one more just to make sure. Here we go. Yeah. So the trick still works. Let's see if the motor holds up and can do the different speeds. I'm sure it will now. Everything's working. I'm impressed. You saw it. It wasn't that hard of a fix. Again, it wasn't pretty the way I did it, but I did it. So that's speed one. Let's get him on speed two. Nice. I love the way this little drone sounds. So much power in these motors. Even though they're not brushless motors, it's still pretty damn powerful for mini drones. Oh, there he goes. So, we fixed it. It worked. It didn't take long at all. And he flies like he did when I got him out of the box. So awesome. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Remember to like and subscribe. Be safe out there. Have fun. Again, don't be a drone dummy. Make sure you check out the video I did on the unboxing on this HS340. This is a great little mini drone, or that kind of didn't make sense, but it's a great mini drone. So go check out the video. Check out all my other videos at Hub City Gadgets, and we'll see you next time.